What's going on, everybody? I have no direction for this video whatsoever, so. And I was loading up again, and I figured I'd just make a video because I don't make them enough because I'm busy. So, going to use the snapper tomorrow. I just put the new belts on it. Another set of belts. You know, there ain't no sense in that. Snapper ought to be ashamed of their mother freaking selves. $110 a piece. So, I wish Snapper would watch this and know that they're a bunch of mother freaking cheapskates. $110 a piece for a C-belt. It's a double V-belt stuck together. Look it up if you want to. $110 a piece. Parts tree. Jack's small engines are always cheaper if you noticed. I made an order today. I got the skag tore apart right now. And I knew it was leaking and I was right. And I ordered them today. It'll have a new crank seal this week. And I'm still using the same trimmers. I'm still wearing this. I mean, look how many hours is on this trimmer. It's just amazing. Husqvarna's nasty now. I've used it so much. And the 94, of course. But I did switch to speed feed on the 94. I hate this little gap. But the dude that works for me loves this thing. My 94. It's more productive to go speed feed 450. Like, if you remember my Echo video, a 2620, the review, I hated that 400 speed feed head. I hated how it dug in the dirt and stuff, but the 450s remedy that. So I recommend those heads to anybody. So the 94's got a 450 speed feed head, and the Husqvarna don't. I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know what trimmers I'm going to roll with. I might switch all to all Echo. Not sell my steels. Broke my heart, my local steel dealer's selling out. And they've been in business for 30 some years. So I'm not going to have a local steel dealer. I'll have to drive 10 minutes away. Echo dealer. Shoot, they're 35, 40 minutes away. But you know what? Echo's been so good to me. I think I'm going to get another one of those. Because my 90Rs, I bought some rebuild kits. But the more I use this thing right here, I'm not knocking a steel. I'm a steel man. But that don't mean I can't use and love this Echo. Man, this thing right here, me and him's buddies. I'm just so used to it and I like it so much. I love this freaking Echo 2620T. I thought about buying another Echo trimmer, but I can't make up my mind. I can order one from Home Depot online, but to get this type, I'd have to drive 30 minutes plus away. I don't really want to do that. Or I done have another one of these. I'm serious, too. That is your... It's kind of like the step between a 4-mix and a 2-stroke, even though it's a 2-stroke. But with that gear reduction, it's just where it's finally, it's been broke in. That thing is fantastic. Fantastic. But anyway, I'm just making a vid to make a vid. Old Snapper. I was thinking about selling him, but I'm glad I ain't. I still haven't made up my mind about what new one I want. As nice as Skag is, I want to buy Skag, but I'm tired of cleaning. Skag is bad for all the grass piled up under the mother frickin'. I'm so sick of blowing that out. And this Snapper and that Toro. See him in there? The Z-Master ain't loaded him up yet. Are very good for not letting any grass in there. But I don't know, this is a random video. But God, those belts, y'all. I love his Snapper, but God, man, $110 a piece. Whew. But anyway, it's one seal that was leaking. It's the crankshaft seal on the skeg. And he's going to be back up because I've done fixed everything else. I'm going ahead and ordered a new fuel pump. Ordered all kinds of parts. I'm getting him all to where he's like a new one. Minus, you know, changing the pistons and stuff and the coils. He's going to be awesome when I get done with him. You'll see him in the next video. I'll film him when he's done. But I've been meaning to make that video about all three of these together. But I'm going to make a video of that versus the 90. Because it's just out. It out torques the 94. It's kind of not a. This is more dedicated. More comparative to a 90R. Or a 110. Because you can get this thing in that head. In the thickest grass. And you think it's going to stop the head. But it don't. That head will just start spinning, son. Even if the trimmer line's wrapped around the head because it's so thick, it'll still spin that motherfucker. I ain't been able to stop that head. And that is why Exterminator wants another one of these. I ain't even took the screen out. And you know I take the screen out of everything. I'm going to, don't worry. He needs cleaned. He still starts one or two pulls. I haven't even took the air filter off since I've owned this. Well, since Echo gave it to me. I don't even know, you know, what it looks like. I know what it looks like online, but I've never took mine off. Spark plug's the same. It's just like the 94R up here. I ain't took nothing out of it either. No, I changed the plug in it. I lied because that thing's a 2014 model. This thing right here still starts one or two pulls. I mean, you just can't. Echo quality of these commercial Echoes and the steels are just a whole nother level. I can't speak on Husqvarna yet. He still starts one or two pulls. I don't even prime or bulb. I just choke him and he'll crank. I still ain't changed the loop handle because I don't know how long I'm going to haul that. I keep saying I'm going to take it off the truck and put the 90 on there, but then I just put it on there just now. As long as this one and this one's on the trailer, I'm happy. This one right here is coming to 94 level of quality. Seriously, I'm liking it that much. I love me some Echo 2620T. Because I know it'll crank just like a steel. I know it'll just chomp down. It's so, like I said, it is kind of comparative to a 4-mix. I'm serious. And the 450 head, this come with a 400 head. I bought this and put on it. And then, like I said, it holds so much line. I just recently put one on this one. I just put this on there last week or two. And then he's got the Husqvarna head. I just ain't changed him yet. But anyway, that's what's going on, guys. Ain't nothing else going on. The skag will be back when I get it. All I had to do was take the damn top off and switch the seal. But it's at my buddy's garage. His garage is real nice. And he has an actual garage. A business. So instead of trying to work on it in my dirt floor, took it there, and you got all your tools right. I had to dig for tools, and so it's there, and that's where it will stay until my parts come in from Parts Tree. But anyway, I hope Snapper, that's what everybody needs, is a good backup mower. Like, this is the backup to the skag now when the skag comes back, and I'm gonna. And then you got to have zero turn backup. So that's why I'm keeping him in case he flops and you got to repair him. I got to get off here. I got to change the oil in that engine again. God, I've put so many hours. Look at my baby. Look at my baby. Y'all don't know how much I like that 770. I still like my 350, don't worry. I still got the same trimmers and same everything. I've got the same everything. But anyway, oh, like I said, I got mad and almost went and bought a new one. I was like, I don't want to finance no more. I just bought that Skag. Cost me a fortune. Man, these mowers are expensive used. And, you know, anybody can go get a new one because they're cheaper. Pay like $100 and some a month. Cheaper to go buy one than it is to buy a used one. But not in the long run. Unless you don't know how to work on stuff, then I recommend you learning. But anyway, I wanted to make a video mainly to, it's not going to have any direction. I don't know what to call it. I just wanted to catch you boys up on what I'm doing. I'm doing so much I can't even remember. I have thoughts for videos all the time, and then I never remember to do it. Winter is approaching, boys. Just like Game of Thrones, winter is coming. I'm still using the, how does people say that from the north? Poolin. It's Poland. And I'm a hillbilly and I know that. Remember how I was going to buy another blower handheld? I can't make up my mind, so I started bringing the Poland. I don't know if I want a vac. If y'all ain't been on Lawn Pros in a while, join up. We got 6,000 members, I think, now. And I asked on there, and I was looking at a Husqvarna because it had a vac system on it. I can't make up my flipping mind. I know I love steel. You don't got to tell me about the 86 and all this. I'm familiar with all the models. I don't know what I want to do. I want to get an Echo, but my buddy said that the vac on the Echo isn't as strong. And steel's got a good strong vac. I don't know what I've got some sensitive areas that needs, you don't want to blow it, because when you got a big huge parking lot, you don't blow leaves around all these 20, 30, 40 cars. So if you had a blower vac to keep from blowing the mulch out and all this and this and going through parking lots, you can just suck them. So I don't know what I'm going to do. You'll probably see a Husqvarna soon. I think it's the one I'm going to go with. It's got an impeller, a metal impeller. I want an Echo, so if Echo would make a bigger one, I would buy the Echo. And like I said, my local steel dealer's closed and I'm upset. It's like I lost a real friend or something. Seriously, I'm really, that's so depressing when I went in there the other day. Oh my gosh, I was like, it's like I lost the best friend. Because I've been in there so many times and bought so much stuff. So it's depressing. But I still love steel. Don't fret my steel fans. I just happen to like other brands too. Like I said, I might go all Echo. I'm really thinking about it. I wish there's an Echo dealer closer, or I'm going to end up having to make my own Echo dealer like I've been working on. I've been working with EFCO to open a shop, but if I could talk to Echo, I might open, if they'll let me open an Echo sales, EFCO, I've already got a connection and I've done been talking to him. If y'all don't know what EFCO is, it's a Italian company that makes trimmers and blowers and whatnot. But anyway, I'm going to end this. I got to change that oil and then get in the house before it gets dark. So I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.